Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your MCQs from current affair perspective. So today is 4 November, so let's see what are the questions for today. So the first question is, consider the following statements related to India Gen project. First, the project aims at carrying out the whole genome sequence of the entire population of the country. Second, it is being implemented by the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. So we have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. So let me tell you friends that the answer is B, that is second. So this project is being implemented by Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. So it is basically aims at doing genome sequencing, but not of an entire population, but a select number of people, that is 1008. So the solution is B, that is second only. So here you can read more details. So genome is basically the DNA or sequence of genes in a cell. So most of the DNA is a nucleus and intricately coiled into a structure called chromosome. So the rest is in the mitochondria, the cell's powerhouse. So every human cell contains a pair of chromosomes, each of which has 3 billion base pairs, or one of four molecules that pair in precise ways. So basically genome sequencing is basically means of deciphering the exact order of base pairs in an individual. So this deciphering or reading of the genome is what sequencing is all about. So it has been known that the portion of the genes responsible for making proteins called the exome occupies about 1% of the gene. So rather than sequence the whole gene, many geneticists rely on exome maps. So that is the order of exomes necessary to make proteins. So program is being funded by Department of Biotechnology. So it will sequence at least 10,000 Indian genomes. So it has selected 1,000 odd from a pool of about 5,000, and so to include representatives from every state and diverse ethnicities. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to smoke. First, smoke is smoke plus fog, that is smoky fog, caused by the burning of large amounts of coal, vehicular emission and industrial fumes. So second is, it is usually highly toxic to humans and can cause severe sickness, shortened life or death. So which of the above statements are correct? So we have to choose that. So friends, clearly first statement is correct, that is smog is smoke plus fog. So it is caused by basically large amounts of coal, vehicular emission, industrial fumes. So it is usually highly toxic to humans and can cause severe sickness. Both of these statements are correct. So the answer should be C. This question has been asked basically due to the recent air pollution that is going on in the national capital of Delhi, there has been much reporting on the issue. So as the issue has been highlighted vividly in newspapers, so that's why the question has been framed. So smog is basically a phenomenon in which is caused by the mixture of smoke plus fog. So fog is basically condition that happens normally in winters due to the cooler temperature. But then when it mixes with smog, this results in smog. So next is more detail about it is that at least two distinct type of smogs are recognized, that is sulfurous smog and photochemical smog. So a primary pollutant is an air pollutant emitted directly from a source. So secondary pollutant is not directly emitted as such. So there are various examples of pollutants also. So these pollutants, they result in the formation of smog. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to International Civil Aviation Organization. First, it is a specialized agency of United Nations. Second, CICA states that the treaty shall be applicable only to the civil aircraft and shall not be applicable to the state aircraft. So which of the above statements are correct? So let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Answer is C. That is, yes, it is a specialized agency of UN, and this treaty is applicable only to the civil aircraft. and not to basically straight aircraft, you can say in it your military aircrafts as well. So International Civil Aviation Organization, it was established in 1944. So to manage the administration and governance of the Convention on International Civil Aviation, that is Chicago Convention. So this has been framed, this question has been framed because recently you might be aware of the fact that Prime Minister of India was denied the usage of airspace of Pakistan. So Chicago Convention was signed on December 1944, on 7 December by 52 states. It basically established the rules of airspace, aircraft registration and safety, and details the rights of signatories in relation to air travel. So convention also exempts air fuels in transit from double taxation. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, the Survey of India is under the Ministry of A, Department of Science and Technology, BPMO, C, Department of Statistics and Program Implementation, D, none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is A, that is Department of Science and Technology. So recently you might be aware of the fact that Survey of India has released the new map of the newly created Union Territories of J&K and Ladakh. So answer is A. So Survey of India is basically national survey and mapping organization. It is under the Department of Science and Technology, and it is the oldest scientific department of the Government of India. So it was set up in 1767 and has evolved rich traditions over the years. So please note, this is very important. Oldest scientific department of the Government of India is the Survey of India, that is under National Survey and Mapping Organization. So more details you can read by pausing the video. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to red sandar species. First, it is endemic to Andhra Pradesh and some areas of Tamil Nadu. Second, it is listed as near threatened species by IUCN. So which of the above statements is are correct? So we have to choose that. So friends, let me tell you that both of these statements are correct. Red sanders are endemic to Andhra Pradesh and also to some areas of Tamil Nadu, and it has been listed as near threatened. So police has recently seized red sanders near Andhra Pradesh border, so that's why this question has been framed. So tree is endemic to several districts in Andhra Pradesh and some parts of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. So International Union for Conservation of Nature has now reclassified red sanders as near threatened from the earlier endangered. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Shanghai Cooperation Organization. First, the organization has expanded its membership to 8 countries when India and Pakistan joined SCO as full members in 2017 at a summit in Astana, Kazakhstan. Second statement is, it is headquartered in Shanghai. So friends, let me tell you that only one statement is correct, and that is first, A is correct. So Ministry of Defense has recently attended recent SCO summit. So this organization is a Eurasian Economic, Political and Security Organization. So India became full member of it in 2017 along with Pakistan. So it is the biggest regional organization as per population. So and geography covered, so it covers about 40% of the globe's population. So chief purpose is to ensure to ensure cooperation on the issues of security, intelligence sharing, border disputes resolution, military cooperation, counter-terrorism, and countering the influence of the USA on Asia. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, the adjusted gross revenue seen in news is related to A, telecom sector, B, direct tax related, C, banking sector related, D, none of the above. So we have to choose that which of these is correct. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is A. So adjusted gross revenue was recently in news because there was a dispute among Government of India and the telecommunication sector that what amounts to adjusted gross revenue and which things are covered under it. So recently Supreme Court has upheld the Department of Telecom's interpretation of AGR, subsequent to which the telecom companies will have to pay an estimated 1.4 lakh crore to the government within next 3 months. So this is a kind of huge blow because already this sector is growing, is facing distress. So definition has been that this definition has been in the litigation for 14 years. So while telecom companies argued that it should comprise revenue from telecom services, Department of Telecommunications' stand was that it should also include all revenue earned by an operator, including that from non-core telecom operations. So it directly impacts the outgo from the pockets of telecom companies. as it is used to calculate the levies payable to operators. So telecom operators pay 8% of the AGF as license fee, while spectrum usage charges vary between 3 to 5% of AGF. So more details you can check by pausing the video. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to TE sector in India. First, India is the second largest producer of tea in the world after China. Second, Assam is the largest producer of tea in India. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you that both of these friends' statements are correct. So the answer is C. So West Bengal government has recently allowed the tea industry to use 15% of the land in a tea garden for other economic activities, including tea, tourism and horticulture. So that's why this question has been framed. So you can pause the video and can check more details. So now let's move on to the next question. Next is, Green Urban Mobility Scheme is implemented by A. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, B. Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, C. Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, D. Niti Aayog. So friends, it is quite easy question. So answer is A, that is Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So it has unveiled much awaited this scheme, that is Urban Green Mobility Scheme 2017, as the next phase of National Urban Renewal Mission. So it is, the ministry is already running the Smart Cities Mission and Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation, AMRUT. So however, these programs are focusing on urban infrastructure, mainly utilities. So this more detail is that establishment of this Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has announced this scheme for 103 cities, and it calls for reforms in the states for the establishment and operationalization of Unified Metropolitan Transportation Authority and adoption and implementation of transit-oriented development. And then travel demand management policy for urban street vendors, urban transportation fund, anti-encroachment policy and comprehensive mobility plan. So more details you can read by pausing the video. And now let's move to the last question of the day. Last question is, regional anti-terrorist structure seen in news is part of which organization? A. SEO, B. NATO, C. SARC, D. ASEAN. So friends, answer is A, that is SEO. So regional anti-terrorist structure, it is headquartered in Tashkent, Uzbekistan. So it is a permanent organ of SEO, and it serves to promote cooperation of member states against the three evils of terrorism, separatism and extremism. So head of RATS is elected for a three-year term. So each member also sends a permanent representative to RATS. So more details you can read by pausing the video. So this is all about, friends, today's discussion of our daily current affairs. So if you like this discussion, then do ensure that you like our video, share it with your friends. And lastly, friends, this is our Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen. Here we have more than 14,000 subscribers that follow us. If you wish to join those students, if you wish to be part of those students, then you can also join this Telegram channel, the link of which will be provided in the description box. And also you can contact us at our number, that is 8968920720. So this is our mail ID and this is our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in. So if you have any doubts, queries, then do ensure that you contact us at this mail ID. So this is all about, friends, today's video. Do ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day ahead.